Good morning, students of class 10. Welcome back to the online classes. Today we'll do geography, forest and wildlife resources. This is a new chapter. We have done one classes before this. In our previous class, we have talked about various plant and animal species of India, and more are to be discovered. So now here we'll talk about the diverse flora and fauna, plants and animals. So we can see there are, right now we have 6 points over here. These diverse flora and fauna. Flora means plants, fauna means animals. Diverse, varieties of species. These diverse flora and fauna are so well integrated, connected. They are so well connected with our daily life, with our life, that we never care for them. We never think about them. We just use them carelessly. So, number two, some estimates suggest that at least 10% of India's recorded flora, that is plant, 10% of plants and 20% of fauna, that is animals, are on the threatened list. Threatened list means, if we do not take care of them, they will get extinct. Ultimately, they will disappear from here, from the earth. So, at least 10% of plants and 20% of animals are on the threatened list. That means they are very critical, at a very critical stage. This is the time that they needed protection. So, such as, here are some names given about animals, such as cheetah, pink-headed duck, mountain quail, spotted owlet are some of the animals that are on the threatened list. They are very critical, at a very critical stage. If we do not take care, if we do not protect them, they will ultimately vanish. They will become extinct. So now, as for plants, many plants. As for plants, wild mahua plant, they are getting extinct. Very few of them are left now. And some medicinal herbs, many of the medicinal herbs, they have ultimately disappeared. Some of them are at the stage of getting extinct. So we must protect them. That means we have to be very careful while using our resources, plants and animal resources. We must be very, very careful. So that this shows. So in fact, really, nobody can say how many species of plants and animals may have already been lost. We don't know exactly how many species of plants and animals have already been lost, got extinct. We can't say exactly. So, number five. We only talk about visible plants and animals. We talk about visible plants and animals which we see. Oh, they are getting extinct. They are at the verge of getting extinct. Or they are at the critical state or threatened stage, threatened list. We can say those which we can see. But what about those small animals, small insects, microorganisms, not only that, small animals and small plants, which we cannot see properly? What about those? They must have gone extinct. So, we only talk about visible plants and animals that have been extinct, which we can see. But what about smaller animals, insects, plants and all? What about them? We never talk about them. We never take notice of them. Based on International Union for Conservation of Nature and Natural Resources. International Union for Conservation of Nature and Natural Resources. Plants are grouped under different categories. Plants are grouped under different categories. We'll talk about those categories in our next class. So, you go through this, go through the forest and life resources, wildlife resources. Study at home also and listen to the online portal, it will become very clear to you. So that's all for today. We'll meet in the next class and carry on our different group, different categories, various categories of plants we'll talk about according to the International Union for Conservation of Nature and Natural Resources. According to them, plants are categorized under different headings. We'll talk about that headings and talk about what type of plants, which plants are under which headings. So that's all for today. We'll meet in the next class. Thank you for watching the video.